Well, I'm very interested in quantum computers, what they can do, how we'll build them, how we'll make them work. But actually, my background is in theoretical particle physics. It's a subject I still love, but back in the 1990s, I got very excited when I first learned about quantum computing and the idea that we'd be able to solve problems with quantum computers that we really couldn't ever hope to solve with ordinary digital computers. And I eventually changed the direction of my research because I got so interested in that subject. I think I got interested because we often are a bit baffled and fascinated in physics by the difference between classical physics and quantum physics. And I felt that looking at physics from the point of view of how information gets stored and processed gave us new insights into the difference between systems that are classical and systems that are quantum. And I think those insights, although part of the reason they're interesting is because they may lead the way to new technologies, they're also useful because they give us new perspective on problems that physicists are interested in for fundamental reasons. Are really important differences between information that's carried by ordinary systems, like in digital computers today, and information carried by quantum systems. And probably the most important distinction between classical and quantum has to do with the nature of the correlations among the parts of a system. When quantum systems are correlated with one another, we say they're entangled. And entanglement is different from the correlations that we normally encounter in our everyday lives. Imagine we have a book, it's 100 pages long. And if it were an ordinary classical book, you could read one of the pages and then you'd know 1% of the content of the book. And if you read another page, you'd know another 1% of the content. But if it's a quantum book, if it's encoded in a state of a quantum system, a typical highly entangled quantum book would have the property that if you look at the pages one at a time, you learn almost nothing about the content of the book. On each page, you would just see random gibberish. And that's because the information that's carried in that quantum system, in that quantum book, it's not encoded in the individual pages. It's almost entirely carried in the correlations among the pages. So if you wanted to read that book, you would have to make a collective observation on many pages at once. And that's completely different from information in the classical world. So even if we have all the information that it's possible to have about the content of the book, if we look at just part of it, what we see is just random junk. In classical systems, where we have a complete description of the whole system, then we also have a complete description of its parts. Because if you try to characterize or describe all those correlations among the parts of a quantum system using ordinary classical data, you'd need an enormous amount of classical information to completely describe all of the correlations. You'd need many more numbers than the number of atoms in the visible universe. So you'll never be able to write down the content of a relatively short quantum book in terms of ordinary classical information. It's kind of an amazing thing. So there's this quantum world out there, and it somehow has these extraordinary resources that it carries, which are much different from any resources we encounter in ordinary experience, and we'd like to learn how to harness that and to use it to our advantage.